Vinyl community, hello, I'm Bruno here, a few days after my previous video. We are in the election period here in France. So I will show some French albums, or not French chansons, it's not for me. Very, very good music, yes. But the first one is not an album with good music, just maybe a psychedelic cover. And it is called Hugo Frey, and you can get the album this way. I just only want to show that because my friend Alain from Belgium showed this in a video lately, and he said yes, the cover is okay, but the music no. So Alain, yes, for €1. It's in my collection. I don't have listened to it yet. This is another message for Alain, this record. It's one of the best psychedelic records from France. And the name of the group, it was a very, it was on stage only a very short period. And it is Hameçon. The name of the group is Hameçon, and the name of the record is Catalyse. And it was it is a Wawa reissue, and it was in the first place on the BYG label. Yes, this is it's very good. It's awesome album from Hameçon, and it is a reissue from 2011, and the record was released in 1970 on BYG. Big actor. Yes. Thanks for the advice, Alain. Merci pour le conseil, Alain. C'est vrai que tu as dit que je m'améliore dans mes choix, mais en tout cas que je vais un peu vers les tiens. Bon, voilà, c'est le cas. The next one, I've got like a story to tell about it. Because when it was released, I was 14. And it is Gainsbourg. The name of the album is Aux Armes, etc. This is a very special item for me, because I bought this record, not this copy, when I was 14. But I lost it. I don't know where it is. Maybe it's somewhere in the house, I don't know. I've looked for that, but I didn't find it. And Aux Armes, etc. Is a reggae album made by Serge Gainsbourg in 79. And he went to Jamaica to do it, and one of, yes, so you see the I don't know if there is such a landscape there in Jamaica. Maybe Doug knows, I don't know. So you can see here some pictures from the sessions. And we are on Philips. And he decided to make a reggae album in the late 70s and went to Jamaica. And he has an agreement with Robbie Shakespeare and Lowell Sly Dunbar. Sly and Robbie, one of the famous band, reggae band in Jamaica. We are said that he was not being taken seriously when he was going there, but when they saw him walking, well, he never stopped walking at that time, and so he was very I don't know how to say that in English, precise man. He was yes, he was looking for the best sound. So this is a great great album. And it is also very provocative because Aux Armes, etc. is the Aux Armes. Here in French, it is the two first words of our national anthem. Aux Armes, citoyens, etc. I won't sing it now. And when he made this reggae version, it was a scandal for some people, and some of them who called themselves patriots, and they came and they came in a concert. I think it was in Strasbourg. You can see that on YouTube. And they stopped a concert from Serge Gainsbourg, and he came on stage and just said, this national anthem, I can sing it, and he sang it before everyone. So it was a piece of event at that time, and yes, in that period we have to think about that. So Serge Gainsbourg, Aux Armes, etc. Next one is Gainsbourg as well. It's a reissue from Back to Black, and it's his album with John Birkin, well known. It was this album was made in 79, and you know, cheap price here in France, and you have here the song Je t'aime moi non plus, which song was made for Brigitte Bardot, and Brigitte Bardot, who was just married, decided not to release that single because it was too hot. So he asked Jane Birkin, his Lolita girlfriend, to do it, and he didn't want, because she didn't want, sorry, because she didn't want to came after Brigitte Bardot. But there was another actress called Mireille Darc, who said, yes, I'm okay to sing that. So she decided to, Jane Birkin decided to sing it. And it was a huge, huge success. I just paid €1 for the Serge Gainsbourg. And when I bought this record, there was another records, famous records, and I will show you, but quickly, of course. €2 for this one. €1 for this one. Don't have to say what it is. €2 for this one. Alive from Sting. €1 for this one. Two Italians now. Fabrizio De André. It's like, for us, it's like, maybe, I don't know, an Italian Brassens. It's a compilation. Another compilation by Lucio Battisti. €1. This guy. Soldalui. They are Breton, and they have a big hit called Durum des Femmes, and it was, it's not my cup of tea, but this is famous here in Brittany, so I have got to have it in the collection. And then some classical. I've got three Rubinstein, one for Chopin, another for Chopin, another one with Mozart music. Then l'Adagio from Albinoni. And for the last record, it's a box set, and it's an opera. It's Carmen from Bizet, inspired. This is the soundtrack of the Francesco Rosi film. And in the box set, you have all the booklet of the opera. I don't know, and I don't understand opera, but I took this one just to see. So I will take the time to listen to it, reading the booklet, and we'll see. Erato. €3. Thank you.